Shalom, family trendsetter. All praises be to the Most High Power Hashem for allowing us to see another day. Now, I apologize for the noise. I'm driving a bigger vehicle today, and it's very noisy, unfortunately. Now, today's video, I want to talk about, and it seems like that's all we can talk about, is what's been happening for the last couple of months. It's kind of crazy, right? Because it's like, sometimes I have to pinch myself, literally pinch myself to see if I'm awoke. You know, am I in a nightmare? Because I know I had predicted this situation back in 2019, 2018, that, you know, come before, or I should say before our new year arrives in April, some people celebrate it in March, the Hebrew New Year, that is, that, you know, something major was going to occur that was going to affect the United States of America and the whole world as well, and everybody was going to be talking about it. That was like a prophetic insight that I had, that the Most High revealed to me, and my spirit didn't speak to me. Nobody hears from God. Gotta keep stressing that. And you know what I mean? And I'm looking at now like, damn, is this going to be the norm? And now I made a video asking people, what do they think if this is going to be the norm? And, you know, I had two or maybe three of my subscribers commented, and they said, believe it or not, this is not the norm. Even before the so-called coronavirus, it wasn't the norm, because the people that rules this prison planet, oversees this prison planet, you know, they're not normal. That's number one. Number two, it's only until the Most High deliver his chosen people. So I'm paraphrasing what was said in the comment section by my intellectual subscribers. Two beautiful young ladies responded, if not maybe three of y'all, that, you know, until we get back the kingdom, the rightful ruler of this prison planet, get back the kingdom. You know what I'm saying? Or until the Most High deliver us from this prison planet, because when we get back the kingdom, it won't be any longer a prison, because the Most High will be dealing with us. He will be interacting with us. And I say he, could be a she or an it, we don't know, but I'm just going to refer to the Most High power as a he. You know what I'm saying? And when that happens, family, when we get back the rightful rulership of this kingdom to come, because we got next, Esau, Edom, Edomites, you devils, Esau the Arabians, you devils, kingdom will be no more, and then we're going to get back rightful rulership. And I believe that we're going to see a difference. You know what I'm saying? We're going to have peace, we're going to have unity. Even the animals, the lion, tigers and bears and shit, they're going to come and they're going to greet us with love. We are definitely not going to enslave any animals, you know what I'm saying, or put them in a zoo. Who does that anyway? I mean, just for entertainment, you fucking taking the Most High creation and encaging them just for monetary profit. You have these devils taking the Most High chosen people, enslaving them for monetary profit, and they don't expect retribution, they don't expect payback. Nah, y'all are living in a reality that doesn't exist, because I believe even though my family members got caught up with this CV-19 or COVID-19, whatever the fuck you want to call it, this anomaly, man-made anomaly that is sanctioned by the Most High, even though they got caught up, it is what it is. I don't know the hearts of my family member. I believe that we come back, we're beings, spiritual beings, and based on how you live your life, you come back to live out judgment on this particular dispensation. I refer to it as hell. Y'all call it. I apologize, family. I got a sidetrack. Actually, no, I didn't. Some call came in and shit. But anyway, as I was saying, you know, I don't know the heart of a man. I don't know how wicked a man's heart is. Only the Most High can determine that. So even though the coronavirus is here close to home, where my uncle and my cousin contracted this virus, okay, let's just keep it at this virus, I mean, it is what it is. You feel what I'm saying? Because at the end of the day, like I said, I don't know why the Most High chose individual or chooses individual to go through this trials and tribulations. It's almost a form of judgment. It's not my duty, or I'm not in a position, I should say, to question the Most High. See, I remember as a Christian, right? I used to question the Most High a lot. Because I remember as a Christian, I used to go to church every Sunday, pay my tithes and my offering, say my prayers, and end it in Jesus' name I pray. And I remember as a Christian, I never really got any blessings. If anything, I was struggling as a Christian. Because I was giving away more than I was getting and shit. You know what I'm saying? Because I felt the need to, you know, buy salvation if I didn't throw my tithes and offering. Malachi, blah, blah, blah. If you dare rob God, and you know how these fucking devils, these agents of the devil, the pastors and shit, they lie to you, tell you you have to, you know, throw your tithes and your offering, especially your thighs and shit. That's what's very important, because they know they'll get more, 10%. And come to find out, when I realized that this shit that they were saying about Malachi and tithes, and I did some research, I realized that it wasn't even money and shit, because back then they had no motherfucking money. It was crops, you know. You give 10% of your crops that you yield. If you was a farmer, you give 10% of your crops. If you was a sheep herder or whatever, you know, you had cattle and shit, you would take the first fruit and shit, whatever cattle that you raise, you want to take the best one and you want to give it to the Leviticus priest. So they was the only one that was supposed to collect tithes back then, and they would put it in the storehouse, and that would go towards homeless people. Today you have these fucking pastors taking y'all money, and you got so many homeless people, sometimes in front of the churches and shit, begging. And these people will not help them, you know. The church doors is closed right now. This should be a time where they open the doors and shit, right? And allow people to be tested in their churches. Utilize God's house, fucking God's house, for a good purpose. But you know, that shit ain't gonna happen. These mega churches is closed. You know how much bedding, you know how much facility, I should say, you know how much room these mega churches have that they can utilize to facilitate these people that needs to be tested. You know what I'm saying? This goes to show you, man. That's why me, fuck Christianity, for real. I would never call myself a Christian. If you even want to say, okay, well, the Hebrews were Christian, well, I'm a pre-Constantine Christian. Which means I don't deal with the New Testament saving, who ain't saving nobody. Because I don't see how the hell you can be a pastor, have a mega church. In some cases, some of these mega churches can hold 20,000 people. And you're telling me you cannot utilize these churches and shit, these institution of Satan, to help out with this, you know, this outbreak, this pandemic that we have. I'm telling you, man, if I was the president of the United States of America, I would make a decree. It would be a mandate that they open up these doors. You know what I'm saying? But nah, that shit ain't gonna happen, because it's a fucking business. Separate church and state. Yeah, right. Family, listen, man. At the end of the day, like I said before, possibly everybody's gonna get the coronavirus. It's just who can actually overcome this shit based on how you live your life and the Most High see favor within you. Because I'm telling you, we are in the last days, and like my subscriber says, until we get back this kingdom, this rightful rulership, we gonna continue to go through hell. Unfortunately, we're here amongst these devils, so you know, it's referred to as Jacob's trouble, although Jacob's trouble been going on for centuries. But you know, we're gonna go through it, some of us, you know what I'm saying, shit, most of us. But you know, I guess according to the New Testament, those who endure to the end and shit shall be saved. Hopefully we will be safe from this coronavirus, because a lot of people are not being safe from this coronavirus. In New York City alone and shit, you know, I remember in one of my videos I did predict that New York City was going to see some kind of, what's that word? Event, if you will. And they sure is feeling it. And it's so ironic, before I go, that it seems like in a lot of these urban black communities, you see a lot of our people contract. It's like they're saying, okay, well, the first strain wasn't strong enough because we was resilient to it. Now let's give them a second dose of it and shit. Because you know, these chemtrails that they spray in the sky, that's what's giving us illness and shit. You know what I'm saying? In order for the pharmaceutical company and the FDA and all these fucking alphabet institution to succeed or gain profit, they have to make us sick. You know what I'm saying? You can't have a rich man if you don't have a poor man. I don't know, family. As I said, you know, when the last day, turn to the Most High, Lord, statutes and commandments, fire the dietary law, and just hope and pray for the best, but expect the worst. Shalom.